Random House Audio presents Star Wars, The New Jedi Order, Traitor, by Matthew Stover, read for you by Jonathan Davis. Outside the universe, there is nothing. This nothing is called hyperspace. A tiny bubble of existence hangs in the nothing. This bubble is called a ship. The bubble is its own universe. Outside the universe, there is nothing. Jacen Solo hangs in the white, exploring the spectrum of pain. In the far infrared, he finds cinders of thirst that bake his throat. Higher, up in the visible wavelengths, gleam the crimson wire-stretched ligaments that sizzle within his shoulders. Grinding glass shard screams howl from his hip joints, like the death shrieks of golden Ithorian starflowers. And higher still, now far beyond the ultraviolet betrayal that brought him here, the betrayal that delivered him into the hands of the Yuuzhan Vong, the betrayal that gathered him into the embrace of pain, the betrayal by Vergere, whom he had trusted, he finds silent, shattering gamma-ray bursts sleeting into his brain. Those gamma-ray bursts are the color of his brother's death. Anakin, he moans, somewhere deep within himself. Anakin, how can you be dead? Jacen cannot remember if he is on a ship or still planet-bound. He remembers that he's been captured before. He remembers Belkadan, remembers his vain dream of freeing slaves, remembers the blank terror of discovering that his force powers meant nothing against the Yuuzhan Vong. He remembers the embrace of pain, remembers his rescue by Uncle Luke, Master Luke, Master Skywalker. He remembers Vergere. Remembering Vergere brings him to the Voxen Queen, and the Voxen Queen sends him slithering back down a despair-greased slope to Anakin's corpse. Jacen knows, intellectually, distantly, abstractly, that once he lived outside the white. He knows that he once felt happiness, pleasure, regret, anger, even love. But these are only ghosts, shadows murmuring beneath the roar of pain that fills everything he is, everything he will ever be. The simple fact that the white had a beginning does not imply that it will have an end. Jacen exists beyond time. Where Jacen is, there is only the white and the Force. Jacen has become a prism, reintegrating the glittering spectrum of pain into pure, blazing agony. Agony is white. Snowblind in an eternal Hoth ice noon of suffering, Jacen Solo hangs in the embrace of pain. The touch of a hand along his jaw leaked time into the white. The tides of agony rolled slowly out, and Jacen could open his eyes. The hand that had brought him out of the white belonged to Vergere. She stood below him, looking up with wide alien eyes, her fingers light upon his cheek. Jacen hung horizontally, suspended face down 2 meters above a floor of wet, slick-looking greens and browns, its surface corded, viny, as though with muscle and vein. From the darkness above swung tentacles like prehensile eye stalks, ends socketed with glowing orbs that stared at him as the tentacles wove and danced and twisted about each other. He understood. The enemy was watching.
Among our masters, Vergere said casually, as though continuing a friendly conversation. It is not considered shameful for a warrior in your position to pray for death. Do you understand this? Jacen understood nothing, except how much he hurt and how terribly he had been betrayed.
I trusted you.
Yes, you did. She opened her hand, turning her quadrifid palm upward, as if to catch a falling tear, and smiled up at him. Why?
Jacen could not find his breath to give answer, and then he found he had no answer to give. She was so alien. Body compact and lithe, arms long and oddly mobile as though possessed of extra joints, hands from which fingers opened like the gripping spines of Andoan rock polyps, back-bent knees above splay-toed feet. He was acutely, overpoweringly aware that he had never seen any of Vergere's kind before. Long, bright eyes the shape of teardrops, a spray of whiskers curving around a wide, expressive mouth. But expressive of what? How could he know what the arc of her lips truly signified?
I thought you were on our side.
One whiskered eyebrow arched.
There is no our side, Jacen Solo.
What do you want from me? Why have you done this? Why are you here?
Deep questions, little Solo.
Her ridge feathers rippled through a shimmering rainbow, like a diamond-edged sabacc deck riffled by an expert dealer.
It is near enough to the truth to say that I am a messenger of melancholy, a herald of tragedy, bearing gifts to ease the grieved, a mourner with grave goods to decorate the tomb, a hierophant to perform the sacred offices for the dead.
Jason's head swam.
You're saying?
Jacen licked his lips, his tongue so dry it scraped them raw.
You're saying you're going to kill me?
Oh no, not at all. I'm saying you're already dead.
Jacen stared.
You are forever lost to the worlds you knew,
she went on with a liquidly alien gesture that might have been a shrug.
Your friends mourn. Your father rages. Your mother weeps. The bright fields of day are forever past.
Jacen opened himself to the Force, let its clean cascade wash through him, dissolving his pain and confusion, and found at his side a connection to the Force as profound as his own. Vergere crackled with power. Jacen murmured,
"You're a Jedi."
Vergere laughed.
There are no Jedi here,
she said, and made a gesture, eye flick swift. Beyond that, he heard and saw no more. A silent supernova erupted within Jason's brain and blasted away the universe. Seconds. Or centuries passed in oblivion. Consciousness swam back into him, and he opened his eyes to find himself still hanging in the embrace of pain, Vergere still standing below him, on her face the same alien facsimile of cheerful mockery. Nothing had changed. Everything had changed. The universe was empty now.
What?
Jacen croaked. His throat raw as though he'd spent days screaming in his sleep.
What have you done to me?
You have no business with the Force, nor it with you. Let you have the Force? The idea. No, 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 little Solo. The Force is much too dangerous for children, so I took it away from you.
The emptiness of the universe howled inside his head. There was nothing out there, only vast interstellar vacuum.
You, there's no way. You can't possibly.
But I have. Really, this Force business, you're better off without it. If you're a good boy, I'll give it back when you grow up.
But I'm a Jedi.
You were a Jedi, she corrected him. Haven't you been paying attention? What part about being dead?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.